and we're going to start our demonstration today. It's all about Archimedes. Now, Archimedes lived a long time ago, and Ashley still hasn't read her little biography of Archimedes, but she's going to learn a little bit about Archimedes today. Now, our lesson is all about when Jacob returns to meet his brother Esau. And on the way, he has a night of struggling with Jesus. And he's struggling over his sin and what he did to deceive Esau and his father and to obtain the birthright in a deceptive way. And so he was struggling through the night over this sin. And our demonstration today uses a bowl of water, uses some rocks, or any kind of weight. You could use marbles or anything that you can come up with in your home. And we are going to use a measuring cup and this bowl of water. But first of all, I'd like for you to think for a minute. Just imagine yourself on a mattress in a swimming pool, you know, one of those floating mattresses. And on your lap, you have a laptop. And you're out there just maybe working or reading. And the laptop falls off of your lap into the water and sinks to the bottom of the swimming pool. Now, the question I have for you who are listening is, will that level of water in the swimming pool rise just a little bit, maybe, if it's a small enough pool, the laptop? Would it make the water rise a little bit, stay the same, or maybe the level to go down? Will that fall, for the laptop to fall into the water? And if it helps you in your mind to think about it, think of a huge rock, if possible, a boulder on your stomach, and it plops off into the water. What would happen to the level of the water? Would it go up?
Yes.
Remain the same? Or go down? Pastor, you're a scientist. And he's shaking his head that it won't go down, but the level of the water would go up. Okay, and that's what Ashley says. And I don't know what anyone else is thinking that is listening, but we're going to give it a try. Now, the gravel I have here represents sin. Oh, those little things that you've done that you knew were wrong and that are bothering your mind. All kinds of, and if the longer you live, the bigger the pile is, right? Maybe so. And then I'm going to slide this down and bring our bowl of water over here. Ash is going to help me. We have a bowl of water here. And let's see. We need this measuring cup that we're going to put in this water. Do you think the cup itself will float? Ashley, come on around here and help me figure this out. Do you think this cup will float in the water?
Yeah.
Okay, there it is. It's not sinking anyway, right? We don't want water in it because we are going to put sin in it. So here you go. Can you help me? Let's see what happens. We're going to fill this cup. Do you think this cup is going to float? What's got there? Floating, right? Okay. Now let's add some more sin. Just lots of sin here. Because this, what was weighing, we'll take that piece of sin out and put in our cup. This was weighing on Jacob's mind, what he had done. Remember, if you've read Pilgrim's Progress, what did he start his journey with on his back? A huge burden, right? The burden of sin. Well, here we have sin floating in this water. It's still floating. Think we can add some more?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's add some more. So this is how Jacob felt, really weighted down with his sin. Let's just see if we can add it all. Is it still floating, Ashley?
Yeah, I think
so. It is.
So.
Okay, now I'm going to dry my hand off, and what we're going to do now is we're going to make a mark at the water level. Okay, we have to be kind of exact because what we're measuring is, will the water go up, down, or remain the same? Because right now it's being supported by water. Ashley is marking the level of the water. Of the rocks that are being supported, they're buoyed up. so to speak, by this water. Buoyancy is holding the weight of this cup with all the rocks in it up. Now what we're going to do is we're going to empty these rocks into the water itself. Just like if the laptop had fallen off of you, instead of being supported by buoyancy, you know, that's what's happening with the mattress in the swimming pool. We're going to dump it. And Ashley says the water's going to go up, right? We'll just see what happens. Get everyone out. Okay, now, has the water level gone?
No.
Oh, no, what?
It went down.
It went down. Now, there's a reason why it went down. It still went up. If we had measured the water before we put anything in it, it would even be even lower. So the rocks themselves have moved the water some, but not nearly as much as when they were in the measuring cup floating in the water. Now, the reason I'm bringing this up is because what is God promised to do with our sins when we confess them? Oh, throw them. Micah 7:19. You want to read it for me, Ash? It's especially the last part of the verse that's important. Here you go. Micah 7:19.
He will turn again. He will have compassion upon us. He will subdue our iniquities, and that will cast all their sins into the depths of the sea.
Cast them into the depths of the sea. Now, when they're on our back, they're a heavy burden. And they just, when they were filling this up in the water, they were floating on the back of the water, so to speak. But it was much heavier and made the water level rise. But when we cast them, when we ask forgiveness, God casts them into the bottom of the sea. And the sea, if it's so deep and goes all the way down, then it's almost like they disappear there. And God doesn't remember them again. They're gone. They're out of sight. And so that's what this principle is. Now, I should tell you just a little bit more about this principle. When it's in the cup and floating in the water is displaced by the weight. But when the rocks are in the bottom of the sea, weight isn't an issue now. It's volume that's an issue. And so the volume of these rocks is smaller than the weight of them, and so the water displaced is smaller. Okay? Objects weigh more in air than they do in water. Because the water supports them more. This property is called buoyancy. Suppose you were floating, and that's what we talked about, and you drop something. So we'll go on. Next slide shows the materials you need. A large kitchen bowl, small paper cup, or I used a plastic measuring cup, etc. There is a principle in science called Archimedes' principle, and it states that something floating will displace an amount of water equal in weight to the part of itself that is submerged. And so you've seen some things, they float right on top of the water. Like if I put a paper cup in there and I don't have one now, it would basically stay on top of the water. But the heavier it is, the deeper it goes into the water. As long as it's still supported by the water, it's still buoyant in the water, then the part that's submerged is, it displaces an equal amount of water in weight. But if it's completely submerged and no longer buoyed up, its weight is no longer a factor and the object will displace an amount of water only equal to its volume. And the volume is smaller, or a smaller amount than its weight in this experiment. This amount is less than the amount displaced when it's floating, so the level in the pool will go down. That's the next slide, and the next slide after that shows you a little picture of it. Ashley, if you come over here, you can see a picture of Archimedes' principle. Here is a weight that weighs 7 pounds, but if it's lowered into water so that it weighs only 4 pounds. That means 3 pounds of it is being displaced. The water. If we had a little
spout,
it could go off and it would be 3 pounds of water. There you go. Okay, next slide. This is like our sins. They're a heavy burden we carry. But if we repent and ask God to forgive them, what does He do with them? Again? Ashley says, cast them into the depths of the sea, and that is found in Micah 7:19. He throws them into the bottom of the sea where they are completely forgotten and have no weight at all. It's only volume that's important. Isn't God wonderful? He knew about Archimedes' principle. In fact, He's the author of it. And this illustration of putting our sins, casting our sins into the bottom of the sea, once you understand Archimedes' principle, and you know how deep the sea is sometimes, you can see that they are gone forever. As long as we've repented of them, turned from them, and asked God to forgive us of them, He will do that. He's promised. Okay, now we want to close our science demonstration and see you next Sabbath, Lord willing, with something else to share with you.